Good Wednesday afternoon, everybody. I'm meteorologist Tim Pandages here with your tropical update and outlook on this Wednesday, September the 2nd. We've got a lot going on out there. Two separate named systems, one Tropical Storm Nana and Tropical Storm Omar, which is a new development since we last spoke yesterday evening. Now, before we get into things, I want to make sure you hit that subscribe button. We have numerous videos coming out not only every day, but every week as we get closer and closer to that peak of hurricane season, which is September 10th. We're ascending up to that peak just about, 8 days away from now. Also, at the end of this video, if you like what you saw, you learned something, hit that like button as well. Before we get into things, too, I want to bring to light here that it has now been 1 year this week that we were witnessing the devastating damage going on through the Bahamas with Hurricane Dorian. It moved through, stalled out as a Category 5 monster. If you remember that a year ago on satellite imagery, it was just mesmerizing. And then it pretty much paralleled the southeast U.S. coastline before impacting the Outer Banks in North Carolina. Now it was tied for the strongest landfalling Atlantic hurricane on record. At its peak, it was a Cat 5 with winds sustained of 185 miles an hour. All right, Omar has formed, and once again, it's a record breaker, the earliest occurrence of the O-named storm since we started naming storms back in the 1950s. Previous record, another 2005 one that we're beating out, and that was Ophelia on September 7th of that year. Here's a look at the list. We've now filled in 15 names. We only have six left out of the 21 names here. We talked about yesterday what happens if we run out. We resort over to the Greek alphabet, and the way things are going, that's a pretty good likelihood. We got a great question yesterday on the YouTube stream, and keep asking questions. I love seeing what you guys are thinking about and what you guys want to learn about. But somebody asked, why on that list are we missing several letters, Q, U, X, Y, and Z? Well, the answer to that is quite simple. There are so few names that begin with those letters that they are excluded from the official hurricane name list for the Atlantic Basin. However, in the Pacific, some of those letters are actually used. So who names the storms anyway? You may think, well, maybe it's the National Hurricane Center. It's not. It's the WMO. It's an acronym for the World Meteorological Organization. And what they do every year, they all get together. It's a big to-do. And they talk about and come up with a list of names from different regions that are recognizable from the areas or regions they represent. We get those 21 names out there, and the 21 we're using now is for that Atlantic Basin. And each year they also determine which names will be retired from previous seasons that caused damage and death. All right, let's do our comparison now. I like to do this every few weeks because 2005 has been compared with 2020 and how things were going so far in terms of the Atlantic hurricane season. Now let's go through yesterday, September the 1st. 2020 so far has had 15 named storms. 11 of those were tropical storms, 4 hurricanes, 1 major, that was Hurricane Laura last week. And I've added in a new defining criteria here, an ACE value of 43, accumulated cyclone energy. I'm going to talk about what that means in just a second because I know you're asking, what in the world does ACE mean? 2005 through yesterday, September the 1st, there were 13 named storms. A difference, though, only 7 of those were tropical storms, 6 hurricanes, 4 were major hurricanes. That put their ACE value up through September 1st of 107, a much higher value than where we currently are when we're at 43. So here's what ACE means, accumulated cyclone energy. Basically what it is, it's a big calculation for each storm, and it's a value based on the wind energy used over a storm's lifetime that's calculated every 6 hours. Okay, so each storm gets its ACE value, and throughout the season, you compile all those values together to get the season's ACE. The highest storm ACE ever recorded was an 82, and that was Aoki, which was a hurricane slash typhoon in the Pacific in 2006. The highest season ACE value was 259 in the season of 1933. 2005 had an ACE value of 250. So we have a long ways to go to get anywhere close to that here with the hurricane season in 2020. All right, let's get to what's going on right now. We have Omar that developed since we last spoke yesterday, and kind of a yawn factor here. There's not much going on with this system at all. You can barely make out any circulation with it, at least on the infrared imagery here. Winds, though, at 40 miles per hour. When we switch up that imagery, though, visible, very interesting here. And for weather nerds, this is mesmerizing because what's happening here is wind shear has completely exposed the low-level circulation. It's kind of like looking under the hood of a car and looking at the engine here. You can see this low-level swirl here. Any thunderstorm activity associated with it is well displaced on off towards the east and away from that storm center, and that's also helping it to weaken as well as some cooler ocean temperatures as it drifts off well to the north and off to the east, well north of Bermuda. So zero impacts to any land at all with Omar. However, Nana is a little bit different. That's going to be making landfall here within the next 12 hours in Belize. And today on satellite, it's not looking all that much more organized than it did yesterday. Certainly a flare-up of thunderstorm activity, but this is also battling wind shear. This time coming in out of the north, you can kind of see it there. It's not very strong wind shear, but it's enough to kind of dismantle the storm just a little bit, blowing some of that thunderstorm convection off towards the south, offset from the center, but it is moving off towards the west. And as it does so, there is still some strengthening that's expected. Right now, winds are at 60, expected to make it up to 70 miles an hour. So that's a high-end tropical storm. 70-mile-an-hour winds can still cause some damage. The good news for the Honduran coastline, though, with this track of this system staying to the north, that means the strongest winds will stay offshore. However, they will slam into Belize here as we get in around Thursday morning at 8 a.m. Now, there are plenty of warm water. There is plenty of warm water in this area, so we could see a brief burst of intensification if it can ward off that wind shear here within the next 12 hours ahead of landfall. Numerous watches and warnings are up. Belize has hurricane warnings up right now in that purple just north of there, tropical storm warnings. The Honduran coast, a tropical storm watch. Again, lesser impacts with the strongest winds staying north of the coastal areas there. There's a look at the sea surface temperatures. Well warm enough into the mid-80s, so plenty of warm water here, and it also does extend down to a depth with that ocean heat content. So if the wind shear does die down a little bit, I would not be surprised if this burst up to a Category 1 hurricane just before it makes landfall later on this evening and overnight. Otherwise, out there are numerous other tropical waves we're watching that could certainly develop as the atmosphere conditions are conducive for it, aside from a little bit of dry air off to the north here. But here's one wave, doesn't look like much right now, and in the long range doesn't have a huge chance or a very high chance, 30% within the next 5 days. And then another wave behind it that we were watching yesterday emerging off the coast of Africa, this one has a better chance, 60% within the next 5 days. The next two names are Paulette and Renee on that 2020 list of names. That's the latest for today. If you have any questions, don't be afraid to ask. You can find me on social media, or you can comment on this YouTube stream, Facebook, Instagram, and on Twitter. We'll see you again tomorrow.